Oh.
Lystring. Ett, två, tre. Ett, två, tre. Ett, två, tre. Ett, två, tre.
Yeah, before we get into it, I want to send out a little warning, or whatever you want to call it. This is a very strong thing. Some people might refer to it as magical or whatever the case may be, but what is not magical? Yeah, anyway, you might not want to transition from cooked food straight into snorting aged urine. You might not want to do that. So, you might want a little slower transition as per the usual case. Yeah. This is green juice and distilled water. And the green juice is not fake, as the case is. It's actually made from real stuff, such as yarrow and yeah, all sorts of things. I don't know how many different kinds of wild edible plants it is in this one. 10 plus, I would say. And then it's diluted with distilled water, or yeah, just water, clean water, votar. So you start your little, should we call it psychedelic experience? Yeah, we call it a psychedelic experience without psychedelic drugs or bullshit. Yeah, you start your psychedelic experience with some cold-pressed green juice. Or, of course, you can just chew on the wild edible herbs and, yeah, then transition into Shivambu or fresh urine, and then transition into aged urine. Yeah, this is part one. It's cold-pressed juice from wild edible herbs and distilled water. More to come.
Putti putti honey hanna.
Of course, you miss a little when you do things for show. I'm just going to go back to Maine here. Human urine, aka humanurine, aka Shivambu. Let's find a good spot here. Yeah, when it comes to these things, preferably you find yourself close to water, not wearing any shoes, maybe not in high grass as I am right now, and so on a daily basis. The environments that you are in heavily affect your situation, since it is your situation. Let's see here. Snuff. Yeah, so for starters here I did some juice
and distilled water. This is not a good lighting, or is it? Well, not optimal at all. Let's see.
Sluta harva.
Maybe like so. Now I'm going to have to come up with some creative solution here. So. Not so. The right angle. Yeah, good enough. So, not good enough, of course. There is some background bullshit going on here, and I didn't want the recording to be too much influenced by the noise. Yeah, maybe here. Yeah, actually. So, the first step was green juice from wild edible plants with some distilled water. Of course, you can just drink distilled water and then eat the plants and so on. And then the second step, or phase two, or whatever you want to call it, is urine. And of course, you can just drink it with your mouth. You can also drink it with your nose. And it's a little tricky to do that if you drink it straight from this. But you can do this. This is much easier. You put it in your hand and then you just snort it with one of your nostrils at a time. Nostrils. Or both. This is much easier because you will never get it into your lungs or whatever. See? Yeah, anyway, that was it. Phase two. See you later. Yes, this is kind of like the finale or whatever you want to call it. This is aged urine. I think it's about 2 or 3 weeks old or something of that nature. Let's see.
Look, it går ju inte upp. Vad ska jag göra, Kristi?
Så. Yes. It's very hard to describe the smell. Extremely hard, actually. And also the taste, of course. Yeah, and when it comes to this, my procedure, or whatever you want to call it, is no eating of anything unnatural prior to collecting the urine for the aging process. So, typically, I wake up, drink my morning urine, the shit hits the fan. Maybe drink some water, maybe some juice from wild edible plants, but often I just get out into nature and eat wild edible plants as they are, loop them a couple of times, the urine that is, and then I collect it in a jar and put it in room temperature and have some kind of t-shirt or whatever over it. My voice is a little different here. It's of course due to me having snorted pee in the previous step. This is step 3, aged urine. And make no deposit and get no return. If you put shit into it. Let's say that you drink a liter of coffee, eat some burnt meat, I don't know, smoke, do some crack or whatever, and then piss and let it sit for a month in a jar with a t-shirt over it, you might not get the best product in the world. This only comes from natural stuff, however. Yeah, and if you are a little hesitant, I can understand if you are a little hesitant. You can simply take this and, I don't know, as a step one, put it on your skin or whatever, massage it in, see what happens. It's actually quite beneficial then as well. Of course, it won't trigger the psychedelic experience that I talked about in the intro here, but yeah, this is quite nice. And yeah, if you want to be a little less skeptical, maybe you can do some mouthwash or whatever. And spit it out. There you have another level. You can drink just a little of it. Transition slowly. However, when you get to the high end, or the god tier, so to speak, of course you want to snort it. So, let's do that. It's very hard to snort it from a jar without getting it into your lungs. And yeah, but if you do it as I showed you in step two here, you take it into your hand and so on, there will be a little spill, but it's worth it, because then you won't get it into your lungs and stuff like that. Don't worry about the distribution either. Because if you get it into your sinuses, then some kind of automatic distribution will happen. And if you have a clogged up nose, it will not be clogged up anymore, and so on. Yeah, the interesting thing about this, the main point of this video, is that this will enhance your senses. Maybe not instantly, in like 1 second, but yeah, you will notice it. If you do this thing, and I recommend that you transition slowly as well. Maybe not necessarily exactly the steps that I showed you, but some kind of transition. Do not go from bullshit to real shit. Make it more and more real and so on. Yeah. And then, of course, spend more time in nature close to water. Ah, I don't know if it's visible. Yeah, it probably was, whatever. Spend more time in nature and so on. And yeah, your senses will become upgraded. And yeah, as Harry Matadine says, you know if you have tried the aged urine. It's not like, was this aged urine or not? Yeah, you will know it. And it will have some major effects on your body and your consciousness and so on. But of course it depends on what you do before it, and yeah, how it came to be. I kind of recommend this. Of course you're not going to try it out, but yeah, hopefully I popped enough Easter eggs in this video to at least make a person or two consider it. And yeah, then we'll see. It's really hot here. It's not just the old pee on my head. So, thank you for watching. Of course, do try it out and be careful. Safety first. Have an awesome now. Ciao.
Bend your knees, man. Dude, bend your knees.
Yeah, of course. And after you have done this whole three-step Shivambu session, you will probably need to pee again. And of course you can loop this as well. And so on, until infinity. Let's see here. Let's hope that my penis didn't make it into the video. This is not a porn video after all. Yeah, and of course, I'm not going to drop any recommended amounts or whatever. The amounts are totally up to you, always, with everything. If you want to do like a sip of pee, do it. If you want to drink all of your pee, do it. I cannot say that I recommend or unrecommend either of it. Just do things in moderation and variation, and with some kind of common sense, even though common sense is not very common. Yeah, that's basically it. I just wanted to inform you that you can keep it going and see what happens. If you start feeling bad or whatever, maybe it's not a good idea to keep it going. If you start feeling good, maybe it is. This method is really bullshit, by the way. Because if you pour it in your hand... Oh my god! If you pour it in your hand... Let's see, this is going to be a little micro-ish. Like so. It can't fail. No way. There's not... This cough that I'm going to do now is because of the previous snorting. So don't get any ideas here. Yeah, anyway. Thank you for watching. Try it out. Have an awesome now. And if it works, keep it up. If it doesn't work, don't keep it up. Shup.